Thank you very much. First, I'd like to thank the organizers for giving us the opportunity to present my recent result here, in particular Professor Ogoshi's great time. Okay, so today my talk is on the motive force in the case with the presence of Rashba interaction magnetization. And actually, my talk, I have in mind the experiment carried out in Trans-Albert-Trent group, or other spin-charge conversion case found in many groups. In particular, this the case of the Rashba, inverse Rashba Edelstein case. This is what I'd like to discuss in this talk. And I'd like to consider study this effect from the viewpoint of the motive force acting on the electrons. Okay, so let me start with just a very easy idea of the motive force. As far as I know, there are several motive forces acting on the electron. And of course, the most important one is the electric field. This drives electric current. But in solid, or it's called in ferromagnetic metals, we have another one, which is called electric field or spin motive force. This acts on electrons, conducting electrons spin, so it induces the spin current. So the up spin and down spins are driven in an opposite way by this spin motive force. And actually, this has been investigated many years ago, and we know what kind of form it has. And N is a magnetization. So, if magnetization has structure and time dependence, we have this spin electric field. So, we can drive the spin current by use of this in ferromagnetic meter. So, let me just briefly explain more, introduce more about this spin motive for. The origin of this spin electric field is a famous, well-known spin bearing phase. And this occurs when the electroconducting electron is going through a magnetizing structure in the adiabatic ring, which means that the magnetizing structure is a very smooth structure. And in this case, the electron spin going through the structure gets other spin rotation because of strong SP interaction. And this results in a phase pattern of the electrons, wave function. And this phase is written as an integral over the path where the electron travels. And we can derive the expression for this phase, and we find that this phase is written in terms of this vector field, which is in fact something related to the topological geometrical phase, or when it's in very case. And so once we know that there's a phase on the electron, this means that we have a kind of effective electric field, because we know that when the phase factor changes as time, we have a voltage. This is equivalent to voltage. So we have an electric field acting on the electron. And this electric field, but at the same time, we have to know, it's important to understand that besides this electric component, we have magnetic field component, because the phase, when considering, if we consider a closed path for the electron, the phase is written as a surface integral or some vector field, and this means that there is an effective magnetic field. And obviously, from the definition, these fields satisfy Faraday's induction law. In general, okay, so the sum of the rotation of the electric and the derivative of the magnetic part is zero or is monopole kind. So we have the electromagnetism, structure of electromagnetism coupling to the conduction electron spin. So this, And of course, so the electric part appears when the magnetization has a special derivative and also the dynamics perpendicular to the derivative, special derivative. And the magnetic component arises from the non-coplanarity, like voltage or scanions, And actually, in the case of magnetic scanning, both fields have been observed. So the magnetic component has been observed as a topological voltage because the magnetic scanning has a topological number. And when the magnetic scanning move, the voltage arising from this electric field part has been observed, and it has shown to be proportional to the velocity in agreement with these theories. So that is means that there is a unified picture of electromagnetism in the ferromagnetic metal when you look at the spin transport. Okay, so now I would like to consider what happens if we include the Rashba spin-orbital interaction. So this is an interaction happening the electron, orbital motion, or momentum, and the electron spin. And the alpha is the Rashba field vector. And this kind of interaction arises from the inversion symmetry breaking, like in surface or interfaces, and especially in the case of bismuth silver, a strong Rashba interaction has been reported theoretically and experimentally. And also, recently there are three-dimensional or bulk Rashba conductor, this material has a three-dimensional structure, but it has bulk Rashba interaction. Okay, so and of course, as well known, this interaction is to interesting spin charge mixing. For instance, when we apply electric field on this system, we have a spin or magnetization induced by this Rashba interaction. And in the opposite way, when we apply magnetic field, we have an electric current because of this interaction. So this is called the first one is called the Rashba energy standard effect, and the second one is inverse energy standard effect. So now let me think about this kind of spin charge conversion in the presence of Rashba interaction. So this is Sanchez experiment, and this is a multi-layer ferromagnet and silver and thin bismuth layer. And what they observe is that when they excite the magnetization precession, they have a voltage perpendicular to the magnetization. And the mechanism they argued is that spin precession induces a spin current induction, and then the spin accumulation at interface occurs, and this spin accumulation is converted to the voltage or charge current because of the interface rush. So this is standard understanding. But I'd like to think of mechanism more in detail. So, if there is a current induced, that means that the electron is driven by some kind of multiforce. So we'd like to see what is the multiforce acting on the electron. So we don't, So we directly access or calculate this force. And force is in fact calculated diagrammatically because it's a time derivative of the current density or access ratio of the electron. So we did a diagrammatic calculation, but here I just present a more technological argument. Okay, Rashba interaction, we have a Rashba interaction, but also we have a magnetization. And we consider just a uniform system for simplicity, not a junction. We have a Rashba and SD interaction. And then the strong strong SD interaction indicates that the Rashba interaction is modified to be like this. And you can show that this is, in the case of strong SD interaction, Rashba is transformed into this happening. N is the magnetization, alpha is the Rashba vector, and JS is the spin current of the electron. So this form is exactly what we expect for the spin gauge field coupling to the spin current. And this vector potential, spin vector potential is given by the Rashba vector cross magnetization. So this coupling directly indicates that we have a motive force on the electron because the time derivative of the vector potential is always a force. So that looks like this. So the time derivative of the magnetization is like the force or motive for electric field. And if we include the spin representation effect, we calculated this effect and found that this motive force is modified, because usually the spin realization of the conduction electron results in a perpendicular component, and this is indeed the case. So N naught is replaced by this perpendicular component in the presence of the spin realization. So this is a, as far as we calculate, this is a motive force acting on the electron, but this is what means, this expression means that we have DC voltage when we excite the magnetization position, because the second term has a finite DC component. And the geometry we have here is exactly the same as the inverse Rashba Edelstein. For instance, if we excite the magnetization along this direction, and then what we obtain from this expression is the current or voltage perpendicular to the magnetization. And so this is DC voltage. And if the Rashba interaction is very strong, like in bismuth silver, and if we consider 10 GHz and the small spin realization rate, we still have quite a large voltage arising from this effective electric field. And of course, we consider here the simplest case of uniform system, but when we consider a junction, we just have to insert the diffusion process of the electron, which gives just power of decay. So essentially, this physics remains true in the junctions. And okay, so in this way, what I obtained here is another interpretation of the universal interpretation standard. But okay, so now how we can relate the experiment to the real, I mean, Rashba in this gauge field, the idea of Rashba in this gauge field, is done if we reflect, if the magnetic component of the magnetic component is measured, this is, can be confirmed. So we discussed that the electric component is like this, motive force. But also, because of this Rashba vector potential, the magnetic component, which is given by the rotation of this vector. And they satisfy Maxwell's equation that to confirm that in experiment, this existence of this magnetic component, maybe it can be observed through the giant spin hole effect when the current is injected. Actually, when the magnetization is like in plane and we have a Rashba interaction and interface, this produces a magnetic component along the magnetization. So this, and this field can be very strong, like, okay, this is theoretical prediction, but it can be 200 Tesla. So what I expect is that if we inject the electric current perpendicular, then the spin, spin dependent scattering results in a spin current. Perpendicular also runs to the magnetization. So if this kind of giant spin hole effect is detected in experiment, this is a confirmation of the Rashba vector potential. And that's very nice, because that means that there's another symmetry in this Rashba magnetic system, which is equivalent to the voltage invariance. And another way to access this spin Rashba induced vector potential is to see the optical response. So we calculated the response of the Rashba conductor with magnetization. And we found that when the magnetization and Rashba vector are also perpendicular, we have a directional dipoles. And actually, so what drives this dipole is exactly the Rashba induced Rashba vector times cross n. And this can be regarded as a toroidal moment in this spin charge mixing. And what I found it important is that this effect, of course, you may expect that this may be small, but in fact, what we find is that it has H similarity, which enhances this effect greatly proportional to the damping inverse. And for the bulk, this must, this bulk Rashba conductor, this edge singularity occurs in the infrared or red light regime, so this will be very interesting if experimentally observed. And so this is another kind of justification or proof that there exists Rashba induced gauge field in this material. Okay, so just can you, so as I said, this optical property arises from the spin charge mixing, but the Rashba conductor is itself without magnetization. This has an interesting optical properties because the spin charge mixing results in a so-called hyperbolic metamaterial. So natural Rashba conductor has a property that writes can lights are refracted in a long way or negative refraction occurs. That's because the Rashba vectors, because of Rashba vector, we have a metallic properties perpendicular to the Rashba field, but the insulating behavior along the Rashba field. So this results in a very strange optical properties. But this will be seen only in the infrared region. Okay, so this is a summary of my talk. I have discussed that in the presence of Rashba interaction magnetization, we have a new vector potential driven by these events. And if we, to confirm this vector potential by observing skin voltage, it would be very interesting. Or optical properties, the experiments by optical properties would be interesting. Thank you very much.